Did we talk about how hard it is to get someone to cut concrete curbs?
I
Is
went
it
over this
hard?
yesterday with the sideways saw.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got two guys in town. We'll do that for you.
What do they charge?
I don't know.
So the original con I did we talk about me in this whole episode? This whole thing with cutting the
No.
concrete curbs? So part of our contract at U of T Sidewalks was to cut the concrete curbs and do like depressions because they needed to walk out into the road. So I couldn't find anyone to do it. So then a guy, and you guys are gonna be shocked that this guy never showed up and kind of screwed me over, but I found him on TikTok and he's like,
I wasn't expecting
on
that.
TikTok.
and he's a very adept concrete cutter from Brampton. And he just never showed up.
Wow.
So then I had no one to cut the curbs, which was delaying the job because you can't do anything till the curbs are cut. So a buddy of mine knew a guy, so I called him. And then that guy, what like just for like 3 days, was like ghosting me on a date when he could cut them. Now, I didn't pressure the guy and say, "You got to come tomorrow," or some bullshit. I just said, "Hey, man, I'm fucked here. When can you cut these curbs?" He's like, "I'll get back to you. I got to check the schedule." I said, "Okay." I waited all day. I texted him that evening. "Hey, bro, like just following up on the scheduling of this curb cutting. I'll get you in the morning." I waited till noon the next day and texted him and said, "Hey, bro, just, I'm not trying to be a dick here, but just trying to schedule this. I don't care when it is. If you told me it's a month from now, there's no one that does this fucking shit. So it is what it is. Yeah, give me 2.5 hours and I'm back to you."
Two
What
and a
is
half.
happening in that half an hour? Like, could you not go three or two? Like, in exactly 2.5? So, anyways, the guy did eventually get back to me and he did come and do So, but that was a big hassle getting someone to cut the curbs. I
I've
didn't
only had to
know.
do that once, and I just called the city and they did it.
Yeah.
And it cost $125.
So I'm wondering what I'm going to get charged for these four curb depression cuts.
Yeah.
Because the guy didn't give me a price. I also feel like he didn't send me an invoice. So whatever. Maybe that's why he's hard to get a hold of. But because he's like, "Well, I can give you a price. It doesn't matter. I need it done. Like, just go do it. Charge me your standard rates. I'm not looking for any." So I don't know how much. So you're saying you paid the city 125?
Yeah,
So that's probably government subsidized.
I guess so.
They did ask me if I would get rid of the concrete. I said, "You haven't seen my Chinese concrete crusher, have you? I'll get rid of the concrete.
I got
I got
a
pool."
pool I'm trying to
These people broke an entire pool deck of concrete by hand with a sledgehammer and then threw it into the bottom of the pool. And then cut the steel sides with a sawzall. And I was like, "Man, this is intense." They
Homeowners can be ridiculous.
really didn't want to spend the $6,000 to fill the pool. I told them you should hire the guy for $6,000 because I know for a fact I'm going to be way more than that.
Yeah.
Just by looking at this fucked up situation. So one of the things this guy had done though, he lived on a corner lot, and I've never seen this before, but he lived on a corner lot, and people talking on their cell phones on the main road keep jumping the curb and driving through his fence and smashing it all to fuck.
What?
Repetitively, just once this happened. So the last time that someone did it, he got 8-inch PVC pipe and buried it 5 feet in the ground and then filled them with cement. So, and they stick out of the ground 5 feet. They're like 10-foot pipes. And then filled them with cement. He's like, "The next fucker that comes through here is gonna pay." I'm like, "And you're probably gonna get sued, dude, for setting up a death trap in your backyard. The
That's a booby trap, I think.
backyard of death." But yeah, it was interesting to see these, because I kept saying, "Can we not just take the fence down on this side and run in here?" You can't take the fence down there. You don't understand. Like, I don't know. It looks like kind of a shitty old fence. Fence don't come down there. So, okay.
And I went in
I went in the yard and saw that the fence was installed on the on my neighborhood. In my brawl with my neighbor, they built a fence today.
Nice.
Oh wow.
And they called bylaw on me.
Uh oh.
Yeah. And the bylaw came and gave her, this is what's really, I think, why this whole bylaw thing might be he paid someone to pretend they were bylaw. So they had a printed sheet of paper and they circled it, and then they circled one section of it that said something about changing the grade, which even as a veteran of reading really stupid shit on drawings, I don't actually understand what they're talking about something to do with the grade. And then they said to Nate, if you have any questions, you have to email us the questions. And Nate said, okay, but we don't have any cards to give you as an email. He said, all right, well, just give me your email. And the email was cityofoshawa@gmail.com. It's like, the city of Oshawa is busting out Gmails?
That's like, awesome.
You don't think that the city of Oshawa has real mail?
That's great. Like,
this is what you do in Oshawa? You email a Gmail? This is the fucking city. You can't get like bylaw@oshawa.com. How hard, Mike, you're a computer dude. How hard is that to do?
It's not hard at all, especially since they probably have their own city domain name, right? Oshawa.ca or something like that. Yeah. Cityofoshawa.ca.
How long would it take you to make the city of Oshawa emails that were actually
seconds?
Seconds.
Well, they can't, here in Oshawa, they can't figure that out. I guess all the counselors have like counselor@gmail.com. It's just, it made me think that this dude next door was setting us up.
That now, sounds like a setup.
I am a conspiracy theorist, but I deeply feel that I'm getting set up here and that there's actually nothing wrong with my house or the grade. But so this guy put up a fence. It's not even 5 feet tall in between the houses. So what is it separate? You know what the other thing that happened to this person was? Our house is the last house on the straight part of the road, and then the road starts to go to the court. So their house is subtly skewed, which I know from looking at it because I've looked at a fuck ton of property lines in my life. But the fat and stupid person that lives, well, owns the house next door, doesn't realize that. And so when they pulled the string and he discovered that his walkway was virtually on my property and he almost didn't have room to put his fence post up, he stood in the driveway swearing and saying, that can't be true.
It sounds like the guy who said the bridge was too low.
Can't be true. This bridge is too low. This property line's not working for me.
Oh man.
So now you're gonna stick your bylaw on them. CityofOshawa@yahoo.com.
You should do that.
Yahoo. No. CityofOshawa@hotmail.com.
Yeah. You should give him a business
6969.
Give him a business card with made with a crayon with that email on it.
Do you guys think that this neighbor might be, because this guy is bitter and angry. He's a bitter, angry man. And do you think he would actually try to be running a game? I don't think the city of Oshawa uses Gmails.
I don't think so. We can look that up really quick, actually.
I don't feel like there's any fucking way. I've dealt with lots of city people in many cities. I can't remember dealing with someone directly in Oshawa, but I am confident that I have never dealt with a city person that gave the name of the city and a Gmail. Because anytime they want to make another email, you're right, they'd have to add some numbers to it, Chad.
So they have Oshawa.ca. So service at Oshawa.ca. So it makes sense that each of their employees or whoever works for them also has the at Oshawa.ca.
So this guy is legit trying to game us.
Yeah, I'm going to try to find somebody.
Also, the person that showed up was in a white minivan. I have never seen any City of Oshawa staff member in a white minivan.
Where do you hire actors to play?
First of all, no bylaw person would deal with my 16-year-old son. Like a real bylaw officer knocking on the door, if my 16-year-old son answered, he or she would say, is the owner of the house home? Because my 16-year-old son does not look like someone who owns the house at all. Nor would he pretend to be. So right away, you have to wonder why the officer...
I just found it.
What?
Most City of Oshawa email addresses have the same format. First initial, last name, at Oshawa.ca. For example, J Doe at Oshawa.ca.
So this Gmail is... This guy is legit running a fucking game. Who runs a game over building a fence?
Oh, man.
A short fence, not even 5 feet high.
Then I said, I don't care if you build it. I'm just not paying you for it because I don't want it. And it's not my requirement to pay for it.
Everybody should email that email address from who's listening to this right now. And just flood that email box because they probably have it and they're looking at it.
cityofoshawa@gmail.com.
That's so good.
How desperate are you as my next door neighbor to fuck with me?
Yeah, that's something else.
I don't know. That's crazy.
And to think that would work, a Gmail account.
And that's awesome. I have also never encountered a bylaw officer in my life. You know, perhaps putting bins on the road or dirt or soil, perhaps. I've never encountered a bylaw officer that didn't have a business card.
Here they wear bulletproof vests.
Wow.
Yeah, I saw one today, actually, for the first time. We were doing sod on a That's city street.
You definitely need a bulletproof vest for that.
Well, I thought she was going to come up and give us grief because Shane was watering down the wrong side of the road. Like, he was facing traffic with the water truck because that's just how they started in the morning. And she came up to him. She's like, are you guys done here? And he's like, I don't know what you mean. She's like, are you done putting the driveway back? Because we reinstated the brick driveway. And he goes, yeah, we're all done. He's like, okay, because we have an open case with the homeowner because they have shit everywhere. They have like 20 bikes and like broken wheelbarrows and like flower pots and all this shit outside, and what's supposed to be a pretty presentable neighborhood in our city. He's like, yeah, we're all done. They're like, okay, great. Now they have no excuse to keep their shit here. And so, anyway.
They were using the fact that you hadn't reinstated the driveway as an excuse to keep their shitty bikes on the lawn.
Shit everywhere, yeah. Oh, here's another thing. JP was reinstating the brick last week, and it's those weird zigzag brick.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've seen them, right? And he's going to cut in the border, which is, I mean, you got to mark them all individually because obviously can't cut a nice straight line with them. And the guy comes and parks his 1940s Ford tractor right on the interlock, straddling the sidewalk and where he's working. He's like, I just have to run in and get something. The guy went inside, the tractor fucking broke down there. It wouldn't start again.
Why is the guy driving a tractor?
I don't know.
Nothing
Maybe he's
says
trying to haul out his shit.
Nothing says I got a DUI like I drive a tractor in the middle of the city. You're in the city, right?
Oh yeah, yeah.
But see, in Cornwall, there's no electric bike shop for the DUI people.
Don't get me started with the electric bikes.
They jump into their
their 1940s Ford tractor.
If you got a DUI in Cornwall, you go tractor.
Eco track, lawn tractor. But this was like the big tire tractor and everything, like the hard seat.
Why is that like, in the city?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe it was part of the bylaw thing where they trying to get that out of there too. So the thing breaks down. It's 4 o'clock on whatever day last week. We're getting ready to pack up. JP's like, I got to sand this driveway apron. What do I do? I'm like, sand around the tractor. He's like, really? I'm like, I don't give a shit. Like, I don't care if there's no sand where the tire tracks are. Like, this is a reinstatement.
None of it's going to get hard and it's all going to wash in anyways. Like,
we're not wetting this sand anyway. We're not activating it. I don't care if there's two spots where the tractor tires were. Like, they're lucky they're even poly sand at all.
It's probably not spec.
Right? No, it's not. But good luck finding dry, regular sand.
Yeah, that's why you're using it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, it's just faster.
Yeah. Just faster. That's it. Yeah.
Does Cornwall bylaw just wear bulletproof vests for when they deal with NDL?
No, that's the first time I've ever seen them on okay. site.
Like they're together. Dealing with NDL, let's get the bulletproof vests on.
Put the vests on. No. We've only ever gotten in trouble for that same thing, parking the wrong direction on a road. That's the most.
Is that by bylaw or by the cops?
Bylaw. The cops don't give a shit. If they see the light going off on the top, they don't care.
Yeah.
You've never got
the guy next door said he was going to call the cops.
For what?
I don't know. Call them. They don't care about you.
For impersonating a law officer.
Like, well, that was calling the cops was last week. And then this week was the fake bylaw officer coming by. What level of pissed off is that guy at me? That he's got a fake bylaw officer.
Like, does he not realize he has to live beside you?
So here's an interesting fact about this whole situation is that it was a rental and then he kicked the people out of it and told them that he was coming to live in it. But then he's never moved into it. And now he's split it into a basement apartment and an upstairs apartment. So I'm thinking he might not be moving in.
Is it illegal? Double residence? No.
Well, we did inquire with the city.
Did you ask the right bylaw?
Well, we just should, Kelly emailed them about it. Maybe you should ask her if she emailed the cityofoshawa@gmail.com. How fucked up? It's like scribbled on a piece of paper. What is this?
Oh,
I don't.
My goodness.
We haven't. We haven't had any. So today, though, actually, the fence is going up, and the one side, the boards, you know, like to get the full board, it's shorter, and then you put like a fascia board on it to cover up how all the fence boards are too short or not even or whatever. Well, that side's on my side, obviously. I was looking at it, I was like, that looks like shit. I was gonna go say something. I was like, man, probably I shouldn't because I already got into it with this person.
In my city, we have the good neighbor thing where your neighbor has to get the nice side of the fence.
Right.
You can't leave the unfinished side to your neighbor. You have to put the nice side on their side.
So, I've heard about that. I don't know if that's true where I am at, but I've definitely heard about that.
Yeah.
So what is that? What?
So, you know how, if you have your 2x4s running across from fence post to fence post, you have to put the finished boards on the exterior facing your neighbor.
If there's a dispute.
Well.
What if you guys are splitting the fence?
Then you can do back and forth, like alternating. You know what I mean?
On each side, yeah.
One on each side.
But then you end up with a gap in between them. It's not really a barrier fence.
Well, then you offset them like 50-50 or
whatever. This guy's got these boards touching because in between the houses for the height of 5 feet, we need a real lot of fucking privacy. That's where we need the privacy for 5 feet high. It's right in between our two houses.
Maybe he's going to put a lattice at the top.
I'm nervous now that there could be a lot of break-ins because this fence is creating a lot of shade and sort of, you know, areas where people could break in to the house, providing a lot of cover for thieves. So I'm going to buy two huge floodlights and point them right into his windows and leave them on every night, all night, to make sure that the whole area is lit up, because I'm scared of thieves.
That's smart.
Yeah. I'm just trying to protect the neighborhood from thieves.
Yeah.
You should flood that email address with a bunch of emails written by ChatGPT. Just anything and everything that ChatGPT can come up with. That's like a complaint or an inquiry.
An inquiry about Oshawa fence bylaws. Send it over. That's not a bad idea. I could do that. It does say something about changing the grade, and our patio technically, because we have an above ground pool that's sunk a bit into the ground, and then I built a patio up to our door so that it's level with the pool. There is a part where I think we do have an infraction, but it's in the backyard where there hasn't been any controversy with the guy next door yet. But my daughter's mother had a fencing controversy with the people who live next door to them. And that ended in her having a radio on the volume of 10 every day, all day, pointed at their house. Every morning she gets up, and at 9 a.m. she flicks on the switch that turns on the ultra loud radio in the backyard that points right at the next door's house. And every night before she goes to bed at 10:30, she shuts it off.
Oh.
Seven days a week for the last 6 months.
Wow.
Dang.
I know it's shocking we're not together, but that might have been inappropriate. I'm pretty confident she doesn't listen to this podcast. Oh my God. So
this has been a good episode.
Hasn't been a strong episode. Hasn't been a super strong episode.
I've enjoyed it personally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Chad.
We got a bit of time left. What's everybody's season look like to end it off? What do we have coming up?
Got a bunch of lackluster front entrances, lifted relays. Usually I leave like a big job till the end of my season. I decided not to do that this year. And with the way my season was turning out, I kind of hoped for one near the end, but everybody said, sign me up for next year, first thing in the spring. Yeah. So like my spring looks amazing, but my end of year this year kind of is not enjoyable.
Why do you leave that big one for the end? Like, what's the thought process there?
There was no thought process before. That was the problem. And now the thought process is I don't want to work on a big job in the cold and find out that it's going to freeze the next week. And then I've got to push it till next season.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be pants down in the middle of a big one and trying to figure out what I can bill for and not having things done and then picking up in the spring. But
yeah, the problem was there was no thought process. So now there's a thought process.
I thought we had a lot of work, and then we lost a job yesterday. We didn't lose it. It just, the contractor we were supposed to do the job for needed to give it to their own people because they lost a big project, which is fine. So now I'm regretting the decision of telling the guy with the driveway I priced that we couldn't do it this year.
Can you turn around and tell him maybe you can?
Well, I spent a lot of time at the meeting stressing why it would be more better to do it in the spring. Really spent a fair amount of time on that. Like, because I didn't want to, because they were very, the couple was very hyped up about doing the job in the fall. They were really hyped up about getting the driveway done in the fall. And they asked me when I thought they would have the best results. And I honestly believe their best results would come in the spring. I think that doing it in the fall, you're always at a risk of what if you get, like, say you start it November 7th and it starts snowing on November 10th. That driveway is never going to be done to the same quality as it would be if it was done in the spring. So I wasn't lying, but I also kind of fucked myself. But not the first time. Definitely won't be the fucking last time. So, and I have an opportunity with another project, but I don't know if I want it. So I'm looking at it, rumbling it over in my mind, trying to figure out whether or not I want to take it. Has a lot of good and a lot of bad, but so we'll figure it out. Maybe the great, and I said this to the contractor that called, that because they were upset that they had to take job from us because they know that that's, I mean, they're a big contractor. They know that that's shitty to do, but they also have to protect their own people, which I respect. Cause I would do the same, but I did say to them, I said, you know, the greatest thing about being a contractor is that you wake up today and you have nothing. You go to bed, you wake up the next day and your phone rings six times and you have way too much work and you're too busy. So yeah. You never know. You never, ever know as a contractor what is going to happen to you every day.
Yeah.
So I had no work for trucks last week. We were scrambling around, trying to keep as many people busy as we could. And have a lot to start this week. But now at the end of the week, we just, you know, a big job that I've been cultivating and pumping the idea into the head that we could do this for like 3 months. Hey, we could do that. Hey, we could do that. Well, maybe we should do that. You guys ready for us to do that? What do you think about doing that? Today they called and said, hey, we need you to do that. So all of a sudden now I have all five triaxles booked for the rest of the week. So, but I didn't know that was going to happen to me today. So maybe tomorrow someone calls me with a shit ton of work to do this fall. I don't know. You never know.
I can't believe it's the end of October.
That is fucked up.
Yeah.
This past week I've been waking up and thinking, you know what? Could use a couple weeks off. And that's when I know that it's time maybe to.
What's your end of season?
I say I don't have a lot, but looking at the board, I got three more streets to topsoil. I got a call today for a street in Brockville that I didn't know was still going on. So I got to do that. We may be back at the bridge project, which is a whole other can of something. Because I didn't know until after we invoiced for the bridge project that the client or the GC doesn't pay any more than 50% of everything that's done until after warranty period, which is a giant kick in the dick because that just covers costs for a year or two before you see any money. Yeah, it's fucking bananas. Like, all those trees we put in, we get to bill 50%. All the hydro seeding we did, we get to bill 50%. All the topsoil work, we get to bill 50%.
Well, you know why you got in with this GC?
Yeah. Like, oh my God. And this is around us, those GCs don't get much bigger than this. You know? Wow.
So do they do that on every contract or just the bridge contract specific?
I want to say, because we've done work for them before and gotten paid without a hitch, but for some reason, this bridge job or these bridge jobs or something like that, I'm like, this does not make any sense. I've never been told I can only bill 50%.
Was it in the contract when you checked it?
I don't know. I never looked at the contract. Like, and it very, maybe that's why we were low bid, right? Because everybody else
knew they weren't going to get paid.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's not going to sink us by any means, but holy shit, what an eye opener to know that you just worked for cost for the past 3 weeks or whatever. you know.
The town of Ajax used to hold their hold back for 24 months.
Whoa. That's City Trees will do that.
Yeah. There was the hold back was 24 months.
Yeah.
And I think they did it partially to count on you forgetting to invoice it. So, we used to have a board with a list of holdbacks because a lot of times people forget to invoice the holdbacks.
I invoice it right off the top. Like, it's on there. I don't care if they don't pay it or not, but it still has to be invoiced.
Yeah.
But
they forget to collect. I guess forgetting to invoice it is incorrect. Forgetting to collect it.
Yeah.
Because no one's going to voluntarily pay it.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're right. I'm not saying forgetting to send an email two fucking years later to shake the cage and go, where the fuck is the holdback on that work we did 2 years ago?
So this bridge job, you get to bill 50%, but there's still a 10% holdback on the 50%. I'm like, where is all the money for this job? This is insane.
Wow.
Like, what the fuck did I do?
So what did they say to you?
What do you mean? They're like, you have to make all these changes to this invoice because as per this, this has to be billed like this. And then, like a fucking document of all the changes that I had to make in order to send the invoice in for approval. So live and learn.
So the warranty period is 12 months?
I don't know. Probably.
What if the warranty period's like 36 months?
Well, what do? Your hands are tied. I can't undo the work. I can't undo the job. I can't take it back. Like,
no.
This is no worse than not knowing your numbers. So
this is not.
I'm just gonna roll with it.
Maybe the new thing should instead, because I mean, let's all be honest. The knowing your numbers thing is burnt.
Is it? Shoot.
Just saying, the amount of people that talk about it is a little mind-numbing.
Is route density gone too?
I haven't heard a lot about route density lately.
No.
Have you?
I haven't.
I guess everyone knows about it now. One day everyone will know about their numbers. But is the new mantra, read the contract?
For commercial, right?
Read the terms of payment. Read the terms of payment.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, well. What do? Am I going to kick and whine and cry about it and fight the, I don't know, $500 million GC about it?
No.
Or am I going to bend over and take it like we always do in commercial?
You're going to bend over and take it. Yeah. And you're going to like it.
You're going to like it.
A big smile on your face.
And ask for more?
Hey, yeah, thanks. Do you have any more?
Thanks for giving me 40%.
Yeah.
I enjoy my 40. I'll enjoy my 40%, sure. It's really, well, I don't know what percentage it actually is because you're getting 10% off 50%.
Yeah.
So that's actually only 5% of the overall contract. So I'll enjoy my 45%. Thank you.
Yeah. So,
and will there be a holdback? 2 years from now, when you get to invoice the other 50%, is there a holdback on that 50%? Oh,
probably. I don't doubt it. I don't doubt it. But
that is.
And there was this big fiasco too about how whenever we were spraying, they had to be there. MTO had to watch you spray and watch you tear open the bag for the first time, and you had to hand them the ticket. And the scale was there to make sure you're mixing everything correctly and all this. And we show up to spray. And there's this new Canadian engineer, which, I mean, great. Guy probably knows more about anything than I do, about everything. And
except I'm like, English.
Hey, well, there was a language barrier. But so we go to start mixing the stuff. And I'm like, do you want this? He's like, what? What do you mean? I'm like, you're supposed to take the ticket. You're supposed to watch. I'm like, do you want me to make a fucking video of this? Like, who is going to be accountable? Who's going to do the sign off here? Because I was told this is supposed to be a major fucking fiasco. And now nobody knows what the criteria is to spray this. Like, is this going to stop me from getting paid even more?
And what did he say?
He's like, I don't know. this is my first time doing this. I'm here to watch the concrete.
So essentially, no one was there to watch the hydro seed.
Nobody was there to watch the hydro seed, but I made this guy come and watch what we were doing so that somebody could have some accountability.
Isn't it up to the GC to call that guy?
Yeah, they did. They were supposed to have someone on site every day, but there was no one besides the consultants there.
To stand around watching you. People wonder why construction is so expensive.
Yeah. Yeah.
I got a fun email today. So we're doing work at one of the universities. We're doing these sidewalk bays, which, you know, wasn't work I was super pumped about getting, but whatever, we're out doing it. And so it's the last day. The guys are doing the sod touch-ups along the sidewalks. And I said, do a good thorough cleanup. So from day one on this job, there's been these six ratty pylons in the parking lot that were blocking some of the spaces in order for us to make sure we could get in to do the sidewalk. And also on day one, in the middle of one of the sidewalks, there was a only authorized parking sign up. And I said, from the time we started this job, what should we do with the authorized parking sign? And they said, oh, just pull it out, leave it. Our people will come pick it up. I said, okay. So because of the curb cutting bullshit, this job that should have been 1 week has been going on for 3 weeks to get this job done. So the job is finished today. The unauthorized parking sign is still lying inside the construction fence from 3 weeks ago when we started. No one has touched it. No one's moved it. No one's come for it. I've sent emails about it. So today I said to the guys, do a thorough cleanup. So in their thorough cleanup of taking down the protection fence and taking down the rolls of snow fence and all the pylons we had there, they picked up the six ratty pylons in the parking lot and threw them in the truck. And then they also picked up this stupid sign that's been there for weeks. I said, bring it back to the yard. When I have a final meeting on this job with the head of groundskeeping or whatever, I'll bring the sign with me and I'll give him back his sign. I'll stuff it in the Veloster and off we'll go with this big sign. I drove there tonight just to check the job because they, you know, I wasn't with the guys when they were finishing it. I just wanted to do a drive through to make sure I was happy with everything. And there's a whole string of emails coming to my phone from the office coordinator of parking. And the first one said, hey, we had six pylons in the parking lot. They're gone. We need them back ASAP. We have another project starting. It's the fucking University of Toronto. And these motherfuckers have six pylons on all 340 acres. I need to get this fucking shit back to you right now. Bring these pylons back immediately.
Wow.
It took you guys 12 months to give me a PO for these sidewalks. 40 emails back and forth about these three sidewalk bays. And you need your six pylons to start a new job now. So I emailed back and said, listen, sorry, we're going to have a person on site watering the sod tomorrow. I will return the pylons. I told the guys to do a thorough cleanup. Obviously, there was a mix-up with these pylons. They didn't realize they belonged to you. We will return because it's five green pylons and one orange.
Green pylons?
Yeah, there's five green pylons and one orange pylon. Like, do you guys have a fucking photograph? It's not just six pylons. It's six very specific pylons. Five green ones that say parking on them and one orange one that does not. All approximately 34 inches tall. Blah, blah, blah. I'm just joking. I put that. So I respond saying, yeah, when we're watering, I'll get Lucas to return the pylons. No problem. 4 minutes later, I get another email. Hey, it's come to my attention. It's come to my attention. Like, I should read this email. It's so fucking stupid. It's
come to my attention.
Keeping in mind that Hi again, Mike. It's come to my attention there was an authorized parking only sign on a post that was taken down by your team, and as of this morning, it was still lying on the ground next to the sidewalk. We went to retrieve it this afternoon, and it's no longer there. Can you please confirm if your team removed it? We need to reinstall it. This sign's been there for 21 days. 21 days later, they left into action. Now the sign's missing. So I emailed back. We also picked up the sign as we didn't want to leave it lying by itself. Because you know someone's going to trip over it and then fucking sue me because I'm the fucking person that left it there. This lady's actually really nice, but she's the office coordinator of parking services. She said, thank you for your quick replies. She's super nice. It's just, I find these emails hilarious. Your team completed the work on our campus today. Two pathways. It's actually three, but whatever. When they removed the fencing, it appears as though they also took our pylons. There were a total of six pylons left in the parking lot block space to block space. Five of which were lime green and marked parking, and one orange one. See attached pictures.
No way.
No.
And is this from a Gmail account by any chance?
Can we please have them returned ASAP? We need them for another project on Thursday. Please confirm. I haven't looked at the attached pictures. I didn't know there was attached pictures of the fucking bylaws. I didn't read that. I didn't read that much of the email before I sent it back an email saying, yeah, we'll bring your fucking pylons back. Here, let's see the attached pictures of the pylons. These are legit pictures of the six pylons. Yeah. I don't, why someone took pictures of them, I have no idea. It's a crazy world we live in. I don't. Welcome to Con.
Your cleanups are way more thorough than mine would be if you're taking the client's stuff.
I don't think that Lucas and Kyle knew it was the client's stuff.
Oh, okay.
I think that, we had a bunch of snow fencing and a bunch of our pylons there too because I didn't want to get fucking
sued. That makes more sense.
So they're all mixed into all the other. We had snow fence, construction fence, caution tape, pylons, and then they had these six random pylons in the mix. And we also have lime green and orange pylons.
Oh. Yeah, we don't have all that stuff.
Or maybe they did know that they were the maybe they did know and they're like, ooh, score six pylons. I don't fucking know.
We subscribe to the notion that if it's not ours, it's someone else's problem. And we leave a lot of other people's problems laying around. Because we just don't have time for that.
I pick up anything that I think might get us sued. You could say that the non-authorized parking sign is not my problem. And I would be in total agreeance with you until someone trips over it and sues the university. And then the university goes, well, the contractor pulled it out and left it inside the fence for 21 days. And the contractor pulled it out and stored it inside their fencing for 21 days, at which point we ignored five emails to pick it up. And then they took the fencing down, and the sign was still lying there when someone tripped over it, so this is their fault. That's how that's going to go for me if I don't remove the sign.
I suppose, yeah. I like to lean on my insurance provider in a case like that.
I like to lean on my insurance provider.
They have my blood. The least they can do is something for me.
That's true. Absolutely. Fuck insurance providers. It's supposed to snow a lot this year.
I think we got snow in the forecast already next week.
No, not us.
Yeah, what snow?
Did you guys have frost last night?
Yeah.
Really?
Maybe it was the night before.
Oh, my goodness. No, we got 20 degrees for the rest of the week.
Oh, it's gone. It was Tuesday.
Oh, we're plus 10 next week. I'll take it.
10, wow. That's going to be 6 here.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's Kitchener. Kitchener is going to get, wet snow Tuesday.
You can keep it.
You can keep it. Keep it, motherfuckers.
Is that an episode?
I feel like that's an episode.
I think so.
Yeah.
We're talking about the weather. I think that's the end of the episode.
That is.
Well, not really. I mean, the weather does have a great effect on all of our lives. It's gone for 10
more so than any other career.
10 mil of rain. Where is this snow in the fucking forecast, Mike?
Kitchener.
I don't look at Kitchener.
I do.
I don't care about Kitchener at all. So right till November 6th, there's only one day of real rain.
Mm.
10 mil on Sunday. Yeah. All right. That's an episode. Fuck y'all.